Summer is really starting to kick in now in our garden, and it shows in the growth of some of our plants as well as the death of others. Our crops like corn and pumpkins now are going really strong. The corn is a meter tall already. It's nice and thick, it's got a lot of offshoots, and it's showing really good signs of strong growth. It hasn't started to tassel yet, and we haven't seen any ears, and thank goodness it's not tasseling, because we've already had a heat wave here which resulted in two consecutive days above 40 degrees Celsius in November. And we really had to be careful keeping the water up to it so that it wouldn't tassel early and ruin our crop. But thankfully it didn't. And that's due in part to the compost that we grow it in, and also the fact that I work from home, so I'm able to water the plants as needed throughout hot days. The pumpkins also love this weather, although they do suffer in fruiting as most plants do when the temperature gets above 36 degrees Celsius. But both our pumpkin and corn crops were both planted late this year. Unfortunately, we didn't have this bed ready in time for the planting at the correct time in spring. And the bed was finished a month late, so the plantings were a month late. We would have expected to normally have corn cobs maturing by now and the first pumpkins starting to mature on the vines, and the first female flowers on the pumpkin vine that we can pollinate. But we weren't able to get these crops in until late October. The pumpkins were planted on October 31st, which was ironic, and the corn was planted a week earlier on October 22nd. We will have corn though in the new year, but where we live it gets quite hot in January, and last year we averaged 33 degrees as our maximum for the month, which is pretty damn hot. And we had some days in the 40s and a lot of days above 33. But conversely, the zone we grow in, we never get frost, or we do sometimes, maybe once every 3 or 4 years, and it's never a bad frost. It's always really light and easy to deal with. Our average daytime temperatures in winter are around 18 to 20 degrees Celsius. So you think that we'd be able to grow things all year round, but the problem is, instead of having a cold winter which stops our growth, we have a hot summer instead. So typically during January, or about 6 weeks from around Christmas time through to early February, we really can't grow much in the heat because it really knocks back flowering of a lot of plants. Tomatoes suffer, pumpkin, corn, all kinds of plants suffer in that kind of heat. It's nice to have 25 to 33 degree days, but when you're averaging above 30 degrees for a whole month, it's really difficult to grow things. And you can count out things like lettuce and salads. They just bolt straight away and you never get any leaves off them. So the pumpkin and corn are doing really well, but next to them, our potatoes are on the way out. They were planted in early August and saw their best growth through the earlier parts of spring when it was much cooler. The plants grew really vigorously and really tall and then started to fall over because they got a little bit too tall. I'm a bit worried there might have been too much nitrogen in the soil, but we'll soon see. I've already seen some potatoes near the surface that are fairly big, so we're hoping for a pretty good crop this year. Last year we got some absolutely massive potatoes, especially the Dutch creams, which really seem to grow well here in our climate. But we've also got two other varieties which grow a little bit smaller, and we'll see how they all go this year. If the other two varieties don't grow big enough for us, we'll probably just ditch them and stick with the Dutch creams. Going with the theme of having things planted late, we also planted most of our tomatoes a little bit too late this year, as well as our chilies and capsicums. Most of these plants are hot weather loving plants, but again, we get a little bit too hot here in the peak of summer, even for these plants to set flowers and keep fruit going. Ideally, we'd like to have these plants in the ground by the beginning of October, but this year again, it was late October, early November before most of our tomatoes went in the ground, and we're even planting chilies in the ground in mid-November, which is a little bit late for us. They are going well though, however, And we've already got some fruit developing on some of our chilies, and we've got some nice tomatoes developing as well. We've got three varieties of tomatoes in at the moment. One of them is a cherry variety, which we use in salads. We've got Tigrella coming on, which I'll also use for salad and cooking. And we've also got San Marzano, which is an Italian sourcing variety. We've grown this one before and made tomato sauce with it, and it's an excellent variety for sauce and for cooking. We've also got cucumbers in. We're growing them this year in pots and in the ground next to our tomatoes. The variety we are growing is called Double Yield. You can pick these ones really early and really small and pickle them. And they are actually one of the cucumber varieties which is commonly pickled. You can also leave them to grow a little bit bigger and use them in salads. We've still got carrots in the ground. We have some larger carrots that we planted way back in September, and they're ready to pick out now. I also sowed a new crop of carrots about 3 weeks ago. I just wanted to see if we can grow carrots here in the really hot weather that we have in summer. I lost a lot of the seedlings in the heat wave, and I've probably only got about 6 to 8 left. But they will grow well in this soil and hopefully produce some nice long tubers that are fairly big without going to seed. The beetroot in this part of the bed's on its way out. It peaked about a month ago, and most of these really need to be picked out and eaten in some way. We've already made a large container of beetroot relish, which will last us for an entire year. We've roasted some, and we also like to shred them and put them in salads. The problem is though, we've run out of lettuce because the lettuce is all bolted, so we're gonna have to go and buy lettuce from the store so we can keep eating these beetroots before they all start to go too soft. We're growing capsicum and aubergine together in this bed. The capsicums we are growing are a purple variety as well as the Alma paprika variety. I've never tried drying and powdering capsicums before, but I love smoked paprika, and I'm probably gonna buy a smoker and have a go at smoking and powdering my own capsicums. The aubergines behind are a long purple variety, and they taste fantastic when they're grilled on the barbecue with a bit of olive oil. We've got some Thai basil behind that, as well as our dwarf lime, which we grow in a pot. And next to the capsicums and aubergines, we've still got our potato onions. They were planted last autumn, so they've been in the ground now for several months. They peaked in growth about 2 months ago, and they've slowly been wilting as the heat's been kicking in. I'm not entirely sure when I'm supposed to pick these onions. Our crop last year was actually quite small, but that was due in part to the location of the bed near a large tree. And it turned out the large tree was putting its roots up into our bed and keeping it perennially dry. This year they're growing in a much better position, and the bulbs have seemed to grow much bigger, although they don't look as big as I'd like them to be. No one wants to be peeling and chopping tiny onions, so we'll see how these go. Possibly I could have planted them too close together. When I first put the bulbs in the ground, they were quite small, and I didn't anticipate that they would split into so many bulbs and create such dense foliage. Our herb bed's been doing very well. It's already been pruned back heavily once this spring when everything got a little bit out of control. We planted it in this position so it'd be protected in the mornings, but get the hot midday to afternoon sun, which really suits the plants we put in there, like your basil, thyme, rosemary, mint, oregano, things like that. They really do like the heat and the direct sun, but they're nice and protected in the morning so they don't get too dry. And lastly, this time of year is also fruiting time as well. Our grapevine has been going really well this year. We've had it in the ground now for 3 years, and this is the first year that we are allowing it to go to fruit. Prior to this, we've picked the fruit off every year in order for the vine to set deeper roots. But this year, we've let it go to fruit to see how it produces. It's the table variety called Sultana. It's the classic one that you dry, but you can also eat them as a table grape. We've got several fig trees in pots that are all producing fruit this year. Hopefully we get something from them. We've got an olive tree now in a pot, and we've also planted an apple tree up in our back fence. We chose that position because it's heavily shaded by a golden ash on its eastern side and a jacaranda tree on its western side. And on hot days, it spends most of its time in the shade. And that microclimate has meant that it flowered much later than plants that I've seen in Tasmania on Instagram, which is quite funny considering we are in Western Sydney. Hopefully it's a really good spot for it where it can set and produce some nice fruit. We only have the single tree though, so fruiting will be a little bit more limited because of that, but it is a Granny Smith, which is a prolific fruiting variety.